Alright, so what's in the big box? Alright, let's see. I hate peanuts. Peanuts. Oh yeah, beautiful. Nice. Very nice. Alrighty. Yes, my favorite jet of all time, because of the movie Top Gun and the video game arcade game by Sega Afterburner. So let's look at the back. Alright, nothing really going on in the back. Picture of the kit. Actually, this is pre-built, so let's take them out of the box. Alright, got them out of the box. Looks like we got a map that shows where everything goes. Okay, put that aside. Stand. Alright, flight stand, display stand. Oops. Alright, so far so good. Wow. Amazing. Truly amazing. Wow. Nice. Wow. Diecast. High quality. Alright. Got them out of the package. And I must say, beautiful. A beautiful aircraft model. And, I picked this one because I love the color. It's a low vis. They call it low vis. Low visibility. To blend in, you know, with the sky and the ocean. And I love it because it's kind of like that stealth color, you know? And I picked this one because of the symbol there. Felix the Cat. And Felix the Cat has a very special meaning, a very special significance to me, of which I will not get into right now, but that was what really sold me on getting this version of this model. Also, it's because it's a D model, so it's got the extra radar right there, hard to see there in the front, but and also it's got the latest or the boosters. The GE boosters, you know, and just love them. You know, the picture is not accurate. It shows the boosters like this. That's the older style. Then they changed to a newer GE engine, and they look more like that. So awesome. And it's already got some missiles from out of the box installed, and got some more for the loadout here. Love it. And it came with pilots, little pilots, for which I'm not gonna use them. See, I'm not gonna use them. I don't need to put them in. And the gas tanks, Even the gas tank has that little Felix the Cat. Very nice. Very awesome. All right, let's put the loadout on him. All right, so I got all his weapons on, and it's just amazing. Look how that thing sits. Look at that. Look at all that detail. Amazing. Some amazing detail on the paint. See? Beautiful. Okay, so a little bit more info on this jet. It was called Christine. See? It says Christine there on the nose. They got all the detail on this model. Christine, it was called. And so tons of detail on this guy. And this reminds me a lot of, I used to collect a lot more of these and sold them all. Same scale, same jets, diecast by a company called Century Wings. And back then, like, Century Wings, you know, was like the best, you know, the best company out there. And they're very sought after. Century Wings, and I had a bunch of them, sold them all, and they're very expensive. So this one particular model is made by Hobby Master, and I was like, hey, it looks pretty good, you know. And I don't know, I see a lot of similarities between Century Wings and Hobby Master. And I'm beginning to think that Century Wings was taken over by Hobby Master. This is, so I'm starting to think this is a Century Wings, because I had quite a few of them. That's how I know that, you know, this isn't Hobby Master, this is a Century Wings. But anyway, I am very, very extremely happy with this one. Matter of fact, I'm gonna bring out another Century Wing. I have a Century Wings, and I'll bring it out to compare. All right, so here's my Century Wings, the only one I ever kept. I sold all the rest, 172s, but this is a 144, and this is amazing. I wish they would have made one bigger, 172 scale, to match this one. But that's the only one they made. And very, very similar. So yeah, so this was a Century Wings. Century Wings has the classic black box. See? And so yeah, I had the classic black box. So I sold all my 172s and just kept it. And they're very, very pricey, you know? The Century Wings. Is that nose a little crooked? Yeah, it's a little crooked. But other than that, I mean, look at it. So much detail into this one little 144. You know, so much detail. And, you know, so two of my favorite models that I have. But yeah, back to this guy. I really love the paint, and I'm telling you, this is gotta be Century Wings. I don't know, I was a big, huge Century Wings fan, and most likely looks like they made some sort of deal, because they're very, very similar. this is how I remember Century Wings was. This high, the highest quality, the highest detail. I mean, Jesus. So, yeah, it makes me want to watch the Top Gun or play that Afterburner arcade game. So, yep, that's where I'm going to keep them. Next to that guy. Thought it was appropriate to bring this guy out. And, have a bunch of little jets up here. Thank you for watching. Bye.